Welcome to the East Minute, reviewing the practice management guidelines for prehospital spine immobilization and penetrating trauma. Spine immobilization is part of most EMS protocols despite a lack of evidence demonstrating efficacy as well as concern for associated complications. Potential complications include local pressure injury, increased intracranial pressure, covering penetrating wounds leading to missed injury, and decreasing success of life-saving procedures, particularly intubation. Even with proper application, functional immobilization is often not achieved. Most penetrating injuries to the spinal cord are complete and unlikely to benefit from immobilization. Using grade methodology, two PICO questions were studied. First, in adult penetrating trauma patients, does spine immobilization decrease mortality? Second, does spine immobilization decrease the incidence of neurologic deficit or potentially reversible deficit? Four studies had sufficient data points for PICO question 1 and were considered moderate quality evidence. No study showed a mortality benefit for spine immobilization, and there was a relative risk of 2.4 for increased mortality with spine immobilization. The authors conclude that spine immobilization does not decrease mortality and is associated with increased mortality. Four studies had sufficient data points for PICO question 2 and were considered very low quality evidence. There were no significant differences in neurologic deficit. The authors conclude that spine immobilization does not decrease neurologic deficit or potentially reversible neurologic deficit. Spine immobilization is associated with increased mortality and has no benefit in preventing neurologic deterioration. Most patients would place a higher value on survival, even with potential neurologic deficits. The authors make a strong recommendation that spine immobilization should not be used routinely for adult patients with penetrating trauma.